Hello everyone, welcome to the Jewish Week Online. What does it mean to have a relative that is so honest and compassionate? It's sometimes complicated. In the new movie, Our Idiot Brother, Paul Rudd plays Ned, a man who is really a little bit inept, but extremely loving and trying to bring his family together. We had the opportunity to sit down with the director and writer of Our Idiot Brother. Let's take a closer look.
Officer Washburn, how you doing today?
Listen, Ned, you wouldn't happen to know where I can get some,
Even if I did, do you really think I'd tell you?
It's been a hard week.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Here you go, officer.
Hey, thanks, man.
Wow. Hey, I'm Ned.
They let me go early.
Yeah, I won most cooperative inmate, 4 months running.
God, Ned just showed up.
You said your door was always open.
Well, I gotta get back to work on the tumion.
The what?
It's a cross-pollination between a tomato and onion. Think of the time it'll save when you're making spaghetti sauce.
He's family. Can't just turn my back on him for no reason.
What did you call?
I need to find you.
I never wanted him here, filling the kids' heads with stupidity.
Check it out.
Can't one of you just take him, please?
What's wrong with my sister? She's pretty, but she's bossy.
Tell me exactly what he said.
He said that your personality gets in the way of your looks, your very good looks.
Dude, do you have Tourette's?
She's open to pretty much anyone. She even slept with our cousin once.
Our idiot brother just ruined my freaking life.
I like to think that if you put your trust out there, I mean, if you really give people the benefit of the doubt, see their best intentions.
I mean, can you hold this?
People will rise to the occasion.
You know, I think it's a really good way to live your life.
If I could love something as much as Ned loves everything,
you wouldn't be such a bitch.
And you wouldn't be such a slut.
Who's the man, Ned?
Yeah, I'm the man.
Louder!
I'm the man.
Yes. Come on.
I try and do good, but I just screw it up. On top of it all, I broke down and smoked with a kid that lives across the street from me.
Okay, I didn't just hear that.
I said I broke down, I went and smoked with a kid that lives across the street from me.
You don't tell your parole officer that you just got high. Oh, man.
Can you forget I said that?
Our Idiot Brother is a really interesting movie. It brings about a lot of different emotions, laughter, compassion. How do you decide to create this film?
What made us, I mean, basically, you know, I did this movie with Paul about 10 years ago called The Chateau. And then since then, he and I have had like many false starts we had such a good time working on it. We've had all these false starts on other scripts that, for one reason or another, never came to fruition. And so when Evgenia and I completed our first screenplay that we did together, we were like instantly psyched to work on something else together. And really, like the starting point on this movie was thinking, we want to write a script that's for that's for Paul, and the character of Ned, in a way, like sort of the first elements of the character were sort of culled from some of these false starts that I'd had with him over the years, and then I don't know, somewhere in there we started thinking about some other casts we'd like to work with, and then got sort of focused on the idea of doing a sort of grown sibling comedy, and sort of just started beating out different directions that it could go in.
Tell us a little bit about creating the film. Whenever you write something, sometimes you put your own personal experiences. Did you do that, and do you relate to any of the characters?
I think for myself, I probably relate to the three sisters way more than I do to the Paul Rudd character, unfortunately, because they are the ones who have the more idiot characteristics. And I think at various points in my life, I've exhibited these kind of like negative traits of these sisters, you know, one who was like completely neurotic about her child. I mean, luckily I have a wonderful husband and a happy marriage, but you know, I was very neurotic about my children for getting into school for a while. You know, I've been neurotic about my career. There were times in my life before I was married when I was, you know, not as honest as I should have been. So in that respect, like, I felt like I could relate to these three girls quite a bit. And but in terms of our family dynamic, I would say actually there's very little of this particular family in our family.
What do you want audiences to take away from your film?
I mean, you know, look, at I don't like to I don't like the idea of, like, you know, feeling like, I don't want people to feel that the movie is some preachy movie that's telling people how to live. But definitely I would say that there's, you know, a hope that I have that people are sort of charmed or fall in love with Paul's character of Ned enough that that when you leave the theater, you feel like a little bit of a desire to live your life, like, you know, to have move to a more optimistic perspective, have a little more faith in humanity, trust people a little bit, be a little less judgmental. But again, I'm only talking in, like, you know, nuances. And mostly I just want people to feel amused and feel like they've been, like, entertained and that it was a sweet movie, you know? I mean, I think the degree to which Ned's character, I mean, I think, look, at obviously on the page, Ned's character is a really loving, open guy. But I do think it's fundamentally Paul Rudd who crafted that character, and I think there are other actors who wouldn't have been able to find the kind of sweetness and the lovingness that he was able to find.
It could have been a very irritating character, actually, in the wrong hands. I hope it's not. I'm fairly confident that he's not. But yeah, I think Paul just gives, he gives him like a certain humanity and actual, like, real intelligence. He's not just like a simpleton.
Every movie has their own environment. Does your Jewishness affect this movie at all?
I mean, in terms of the him saying, like, and you know, Shabbat Shalom with the candles, that was a total improvised line for of Paul's. I mean, look, for me, I'm incredibly, to be totally honest, I'm incredibly, like, conflicted about my Jewishness, and so, and I think, like, that's probably the part of me that is more, like, stressed out and high-strung, like the sister characters. You know, I do think there's something, I guess, inherently kind of Jewish about the real argumentative family, and so I think in the sense that, like, this family is really comfortable, like, throwing their opinions about each other around, is something that definitely feels like it could be a real character of, like, a Jewish family, although I don't think that this family is ever made to be particularly a Jewish family.
Although I don't think there's really a single character that you would call, like, oh, that's really Gentile seeming person.
Except for maybe the mom, Shirley, yeah. Knight.
We originally actually wrote the script with thinking that this could be a Jewish family, and we had the character of the mother was, like, much more, like, opinionated and kind of, like, nagging and following the characters around, which, you know, I don't want to say is, like, a Jewish characteristic. That's more of, like, a mom characteristic. But, you know, Shirley Knight had a different...
She took the character in a different direction.
She had a more, like, kind of subdued, gentle way of being that I think ultimately worked really well for the movie.
What's your favorite part of the movie?
I have a couple of favorite moments, but one of my favorite moments was a total unscripted moment of Paul's in the at the end of the threesome when he's when he's sort of already like stopped and said he can't go through with it, and he's like, and he's clearly feeling really bad that he's insulted the guy, and it's clear that it's like the guy who he's not really psyched to be getting down with, and he throws in like one last kiss on the cheek and says he's sorry to him, which is totally unscripted, and for me, like, is both really something that I thought was both really funny, but I also think is like sort of one of the key moments where you can see how much humanity Paul really put into the character of Ned, that like sort of extra feeling sorry, feeling bad about hurting this guy's feelings. So that to me is one of my favorite moments in the movie.
I think I really always enjoy watching the scene of the two sisters telling the Liz character that her husband is cheating on her, and telling her like how she needs to make herself like pull herself together and look sexy again, just because there's like there's so many different dynamics happening in that scene, with the relationship between each sister to each other that are playing at the same time. So I think there's something really satisfying about that particular scene.
As you can see, it was truly a fantastic movie, and it really shows the meaning of family, meaning of honesty, and the meaning of love. This is Aaron Herman, and thank you for watching.